Let's take a bit deeper look into content management. We have seen how blog posts work, but let's see what else is there. And remember that the site was set up with the blog recipe. And a lot of these content types that we see under content types here were actually created or coming from the blog recipe. So, as I said, recipes are for content and configuration. You can export a blog post into a recipe as well, but you can also export the blog post content type into a recipe and use that during setup. That's what we have done. But actually, there are a lot of other content types here too. And for example, there is also page. So let's quickly check it out. And the page content type was also created by the blog recipe. So if you are using another recipe or if you are using your own, you might not have the same thing. However, we also have the helpful extensions module to help you out there. Our helpful extensions module is an open source module. It also has a couple content types that are quite useful. And actually, most of these content types come from Orchard's recipes. There is the helpful widgets feature, which contains some widget content types. We'll see widgets in a minute too. And there is also the helpful content types feature, which contains the same page content type. So if you are not using the blog recipe or another recipe that contains the definition for that page content type, then do check out our helpful extensions module and you will get the same content types from there too. But for now, let's check out how a page works. A page is, well, just any content page. So a blog post is always a post in a blog, while a page is more like a standalone page, like an About Us page or some other content page. And, well, the page content type, as we can see when creating this this item, also has a title. So, well, that's the same title part that the blog post content type uses. It also has a permalink. It will be auto-generated if I leave it empty, so I will just use it as such. And then there is this thing where we can add widgets. Well, what is this thing and what are widgets? Well, let's check out the content type. And let me go to the page content type. And you can see we don't have fields here. We do have parts. Again, same title and author add parts. We again have an automatically generated content part called the same as the content type, called page. But we also have something else called the flow part. And the flow part is a very useful content part. And this is a good example of a content part that has a pretty big functionality. And what it does is, well, it offers you a way to build a dynamically structured or dynamically flown, hence the name flow part, page and UI here. So you can throw together widgets to build some kind of layout here. And well, what are widgets? Well, let's create a raw HTML widget and we'll see. Now we have this raw HTML box here. And as the name also implies, this is actually to write HTML directly. You can also get what you see is what you get behavior here. This is the built-in configuration of the blog recipe. You can write some HTML here, like hello world, of course. That's always what we start with. And then you can also add another widget. Like we have a couple of images in the blog recipe. Let's also add an image here. And now we can select from something from the media library, which we will actually see in more detail later. And we can also add other widgets here. We can add a widget for a specific paragraph, like here, and here we have now a complete WYSIWYG editor too. And this is actually producing HTML, so this is not Markdown as with the blog post. And now it starts to take shape. As you can see, we can have multiple widgets here, and we can also drag and drop them around. We can actually also align them. Like, I can have the paragraph on the left, I can have row HTML on the right, and we can also specify how wide they should be, like 50%. And now we have the two side by side. So pretty much what we have here with full part is kind of a layout builder, but a layout builder that doesn't just let you build a rigid layout, but rather a layout that will be automatically adapted to the window size, hence the name flow part. And secondly, what you add here are widgets, and widgets are actually also content items. So under content types, we have corresponding content types here. You see we have this label widget here for all these widgets. You can add these widgets, which will be their own pieces of content within this page. And before I publish it, let's actually try out something else, the preview feature. The preview feature is a live preview feature for Orchard. It can be used to edit a page or another content item and see how it will look like in the context of the website right away. So, for example, I can change the title here. I can also change anything in the widgets here. With every keystroke, the content on the right will be updated. So this is quite useful, and I would say it's also quite a spectacular feature. If you close the preview, then everything continues as usual. And as usual, we can also publish this page. If I now open this URL on the front end, we'll see that, as expected, it's displayed there and is displayed in the same way as we have seen in the preview.